We've got some fans' questions on Twitter feeds and Facebook and things like that. First of all, your favourite Christmas memory, Matt?
Favourite Christmas memory?
That is from Nadia Elmaragui. I think I've pronounced that right, either on Twitter or Facebook. Nadia asks your favourite Christmas memory.
Favourite Christmas memory?
It could be when you're a kid, you know.
I remember when I was a kid and going to bed and the Christmas tree was sort of bare underneath, and then you wake up the next morning and it was just like presents galore. It was unbelievable. That feeling of thinking Santa had been was amazing.
So that's a great answer from Matt there. And there's another one here. Colin Mayen has asked, what's your favourite Christmas movie? obviously just try and keep it clean, but on the afternoon maybe, when you've had a few mince pies.
I'll tell you what, I've been watching a few recently. I'm trying to get my 2.5-year-old into it, and The Snowman for me has to be right up there.
It's epic.
It is epic. The soundtrack is incredible.
Are the tears at the end though, Matt?
Oh, absolutely, every time, even now well up.
That's one of mine. This is from Ed Armishaw. When was the last time you guys actually got to spend Christmas at home? Can you remember?
Well, I was trying to work it out the other day. It was 9 years since we had, the full run into Christmas, December, the whole of December and into Christmas. Usually we are either landing on Christmas Eve from somewhere and then jetting off pretty soon afterwards. The last 2 years, South Africa and Australia, we've actually been in hotel rooms in those countries, which is just diabolical, to be honest. It's not Christmas. So really looking forward to this year.
However, it is a lot warmer out there, isn't it? Because it's freezing now.
It is, but you know what? I'm going to say something unpopular here. I'm actually really enjoying this weather because we haven't had it. As I say, it's been 8-9 years we're actually having a winter in England. And even at going dark, early is something that's new for the boys. So I don't mind it at the moment.
No, absolutely. Well, we've got a few more here and then you can get back in. Paul Andrew has asked, do you bake your own mince pies or any bake here at Christmas? Who does the cooking?
I don't do any cooking. I tried to oven bake cheese on toast the other day. That's how bad I am. I tried to oven bake cheese on toast the other day. So that's how bad I am. Baking I leave strictly to my missus.
And if you had the, this is from Hector. If you had to send the Queen a Christmas gift, what would it be? Obviously, if you had to get no good books, what would you send her?
A flat peak cap.
One of the stranger ones, it's got to be said.
Well, there you go. Strange question, strange answer.
And finally, I guess we've kind of covered it a little bit, but what are your aims for 2012? Obviously, as a team, you want to remain at number one, but personal aims, have you got any of those? Do you set targets? What's coming up, I guess?
Yeah, I try and set targets before each test series, really. And I've not yet set mine for the next test. I'm still in Christmas mode, to be honest, and golf mode. But, come up to Dubai and Abu Dhabi in the Pakistan series, I'll certainly have goals and aspirations like I have done every other series. And, I mean, quite honestly, it's to keep performing consistently and scoring runs when they're needed and hopefully put England in winning positions.
I guess rolling off that, any New Year's resolutions? That's from me.
Not yet. There probably should be. But they only get broken, don't they? So
it's
there's
true.
No point,
it's
really.
True, like a day later.
Exactly.